Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I finally found where to go. I spent about a half hour wandering around and I accidentally fell off the edge once, but I managed to recover my souls and finally found it. So it's up here where I... I originally got here by falling... After I fought the two gargoyles up on the roof, I fell down to the outside of that broken window, I think. And then I kicked down the ladder. I'm pretty sure that's how I got here. But yeah, anyway, the place... Whoops. Thank you, ladder, for protecting me. Anyway, like I was saying, the area that I forgot to go to was this way. I remember heading over this way, and I remember reading the message by the door there that says something like, taking on one at a time required ahead. Yeah, I remember reading that, so I definitely went to this door, but then I guess I went back and completely forgot about this area. Before I go out the door, though, let's go a different way. Also, I remember seeing something. Yeah, there we go. Some of those little bastards up there. And also, another one of those slug creatures up in the rafters. So there must be some way to get up into the rafters. Aw, come on. Whew. Stabbed it like one frame before it hit me. Be wary of above. Well, a little late for that. Also, that's some very interesting texture work. I can't zoom up anymore. Red-eyed knight. Actually, wait, I fought that knight. Yeah, I didn't come in from the window, I came in from over here. Where's over here? I'm not gonna fight it since I've already fought it before and I'm low on Estus, but I wanna know how I got in here. Right, the gargoyle. Okay, now it's starting to make sense. Okay. Alright, let's hope my three Estuses last me long enough to find a bonfire. I see three enemies on the steps. Be wary of Trio. There's a trio of enemies, and there's also a trio of statues. Coincidence? Probably not. This one's ice blasted. Looks to be a king, some perhaps scholarly or mage person, and then... Don't know who they are, but they're praying, it looks like. Oh, well, I guess there's more statues. That thing's terrifying looking. Also, I recognize it. I'm pretty sure that was in Dark Souls 1. Yeah, wasn't that in Dark Souls 1? It was in that gigantic hole that you can fall down in, and it goes to someplace. Anyway, let's see if I can just pull one. Oh, it worked! Or did it? Nope. That didn't work. Also, wow, they're fast. Holy shit. I'm scared. They're really, 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 really fast. Let's try to take out the mages first. Oh my god, they have Estus! Oh! That's not a very good time to invade other worlds. Actually, it might be a good time. I think it's gonna reset the encounter, right? Trespasser Pussy. Very flexible. Trying to stretch out their body. Oh, is that them? Uh-oh. That thing's coming for me, isn't it? Did I do any damage? Holy lag! Man, their, like, leaping air attack is so cool looking. I wonder what weapon that is. Yep, encounter reset. For better or for worse. It'll be for better if I can manage to pull one at a time, but I don't think I can. Come on. What are you doing? You have a bow. You should probably use it. What? Why do the other ones only come after a little while? I don't get it. At first, they didn't seem to know about me. Oh, Christ. That one's really terrifying, the one with the axe. Oh no, my god, it keeps parrying me, but at least it's not actually doing anything with the parry. I'm just gonna run and see if I can find a bonfire. Bonnie, that's not a bonfire, but it's a thingy. Go! Oh, I'm safe. I don't know where this goes. Where does this go? Hopefully I'm opening up a shortcut or something? Oh my god! It is a shortcut, isn't it? This is, the beginning bonfire! Oh. That makes things easier. Now I could probably backstab him. Could this be a liar? That creepy thing? Of course I intend to go back and fight him, but I just want to take a little look around here. If I could maybe drop down and stab him? Do a plunging attack? Another big battlefield. And I see soldiers waiting behind those shield things. I don't know what they're called. Keen senses. Whoa, this goes up and up and up. Oh. Do you see that? Maybe I'll go fight them first. They're not coming up to get me, are they? Where are they? Where'd they go? Oh, that's weird. Let's see if I can backstab the mage one. I was thinking, like, why am I drinking my Estus so slow? How come I can't move? And I just realized I still had my binoculars equipped. Alright, well, no big deal. It'll take me like 10 seconds to get back there. Probably a good time to take an ember. That backstab didn't work, so instead I'm gonna do this. God, they're amazing at parrying. They never do anything with it, but they're so good at it. One more, one more, one more! Okay, one down, one down. I can deal with two, probably. Yes! Okay, I can definitely deal with one. Golden Wing Crest Shield. Looks like each one drops something, probably a valuable piece of equipment. Wait, what am I skipping through? I don't know what the hell I was pressing. A blue knight shield engraved with a golden wing crest. The shield is exceptional amongst the enchanted blue shields. Not only does it boast high magic absorption, but also enables its wielder to parry spells. Ooh, sounds nice. Yeah, I think I remember a shield like that in Dark Souls 2. Very cool. Crystal staff. Was that one, right? Was it that one? Yeah, it's gotta be. It's either that or crystal chime, but I don't think it was a chime, it was a staff. Crystal catalyst presented as a gift by the crystal sages to their favorite pupil. Cream healed. Something like that. Crystal spheres devour the will of the user, and this staff increases the potency of sorceries at the cost of increased FP consumption for skills. Ooh. I wonder if that's the weapons that person I invaded was using. Actually, let's use it in my main slot so I can compare the damage. Well, let's read the stats first. The hunter is known as the King's Black Hands wielded paired weapons. These belong to Goddard, who fled the castle. Goddard rose quickly through the knighthood, no surprise to those who have witnessed his swordsmanship. So, damage, how does it compare? Hard to tell, because that's obviously plus 0, whereas my current weapon is plus 10. Scaling. Better scaling and strength. Only descaling and dexterity. So even if I made it sharp, it would just become C, which is still worse than my current scaling on dex. So probably not a very good dex build weapon, and I'm definitely a dex build. Let's try him out. Alright, quick dual wield attacks. I think that might have been what they were using. Let's do the strong attack. Maybe not. I'm not seeing that jump. That jump attack. Well, that's kind of cool. If you roll and then do a quick attack. It's a forward stab. That's actually really cool looking. Good amount of reach. Can you do, like, a leaping attack with dual-wielded weapons? That's not a dual-wield leaping attack. I don't know. Yeah, I don't think that's what they were using. I don't see any leaps, but it's still a very cool weapon. Try sorcery. Not gonna work in my case. Anything special around here? Someone got over there. I see messages. Visions of sadness. Gorgeous view. Oh my god, it is a gorgeous view. Praise the demons. And the sun. Which is covered. Be wary of enemy. Hmm? Is something going to attack me when I take this? Estus shard, nice. What enemy? Lies. I can hear them breathing. What the heck is the point of this place? Tight spot, indeed. Bizarre. Time for hitting them in one swoop. Are they below me? Or are they above me? I think they're above me. Hunter's ring, what's that? Increases dexterity. Ooh, by how much? By 5. That is going to give me significantly more damage. Let's see just how much. No, not inventory character. Status? Yes. So, right weapon 1, 322. 322. What should we replace? I guess this is the least important one, the Estus ring. So, from 322 to 338. 322 to 338. That's a pretty good increase. Yeah. I think I'll go with that. I think that's more important than Estus. So, how do I fight them? I can just target them. Alright, let's throw a throwing knife at him, I guess. Fight me. Oh, okay. Okay, that was pretty awesome. Oh, I don't want to. Run. Oh, where's that go? I don't know. Oh, I see. Perfect. Perfect. Perfect place to go. Please don't follow me. Oh. Okay. Yeah, there's that giant birdcage I saw from down below. I think I gotta fall onto it. Whew! They're too big to fit through the hole. Those are strange and beautiful creatures. What the hell do I do from here? Where do I go? Oh, shit. I didn't even see that hole. To find pillars of light. Is that a spellbook? Or just a spell? Oh, just a spell. Multiple pillars of light in vicinity. I think I fought against an enemy that had that. Uh-oh. Aw, you're not a good slug. Unlike that other one. Is it shooting doves at me? Those look like birds. Actually, I think it is. I even see feathers exploding out when it hits. Yeah, look at that. Poor birds. Holy gem. Alright, let's drop down right here. Despawned. Anything else up here? Let's make sure there's nothing hidden over here. Nope. Also want to take a look at that gem. Oh, I've actually already gotten one of those before. Could turn my weapon into a holy blade. Special blessed weapons gradually restore HP and heavily damage reanimated foes. You know? Sometimes I wish I played this game a different way. Because there's all these gems and I don't use any of them. I just found the sharp gem, used it because it fits with my dex build, and then just went with that. But look at all these other gems that I just don't use at all. It's over a dozen. I don't know how that'd play, like, how you'd use these effectively. The only thing I can think of is if you had multiple sets of weapons, you kept them all upgraded as much as possible, which would be quite difficult. I mean, it wasn't that long ago that I just got my weapon to plus 10. So if you had two weapons, then that'd be much slower to get it there. But the only thing I can think of is you have multiple sets of weapons with different properties depending on what you're fighting. Like, if you're going into the sewers and you're fighting lots of zombie things, you might have a blessed weapon, that sort of thing. But I don't know, that just doesn't seem worth it to me. I'd rather just focus on one thing and get it working, but there's just so much variety that I'm missing. Food for thought. What the heck is this? Oh! That leads down here. Okay. Alright, let's go back. Yeah, let's actually go back to the shrine. I want to use my Estus shard. Make sure I don't have any undead bone shards as well knocking around my inventory that I forgot about. Nope. I really love the level design of the Grand Archives the more I play it. It was a little bit frustrating at first because it seemed so labyrinthian and maze-like that I just didn't know where the heck to go, but now I've explored almost all of it. And I don't know, it's pretty neat that you just keep unlocking more and more levels of... like, not levels, more and more layers of this level. of this environment. Rather than finding more bonfires, you just find tons of shortcuts. Because I haven't found a single bonfire inside of the Grand Archives. It's all been shortcuts. And it's really cool. That's something that doesn't happen very often. Alright, so it seems like they jump down and try to kill you. If I just walk in front. So it seems like my old... The thing I did originally of just running around the side was the right way to go. Let's see if this is to the side enough. I think I'll do the same thing I did before, except this time not fight it in front where the others drop down. Get a target. Oh, come on. I know you're the one I hit before. Come on. No. There's got to be a better way to do this, right? Come on, how did I do it before? Ah. Alright, I'm just gonna run in front and see if I can get one. Please just be one. No, it's multiple, but they're not actually aggroed on me, they're just... there. And one's patrolling around the back, so let's go get that one's attention. Oh crap, I meant to heal. Very cool enemy. Got his attention. Whoa! Ooh. Missing that Estus ring. Yeah, that Estus ring actually made a huge difference. Alright, one more to go. Oh, just hanging out over there. What's your weapon of choice? Same as the other one. Dodge constantly. Titanite slab. I think that's what you need to take a weapon to plus 10, right? I think I've only gotten one other of that before. Yeah, those were really cool enemies. There's nothing more to do in here, right? I didn't really check out the bottom floor. I just ran in here and then fell down the hole. Yeah, looks like that's it. Oh yeah, there's one more thing I want to try. Is there anything up here? No? That'd be no. If I wanted to be wise, I should probably go back and restore my Estus, but eh, I don't feel like it. Then again, I do have a large amount of souls. Yeah, I should go back. I didn't realize I had over 100,000 souls.
Well, very well then,
Hagen. 1, 2, 3, 3, almost 4 levels. Vigor, sure. Endurance, sure. Dex is pretty good. Yeah, I don't even really have to worry about Dex if I'm gonna stick with that ring. Not that it hurts to have more damage, of course. Let's get more stamina. Yeah, I'm actually seriously considering going back to using the Estus ring. I didn't realize what a huge difference that made. It makes a big difference. But I'll stick with this for now, because there's not really that much of a reason to worry about it if I'm not running out of Estus. Those enemies respawn? Nope, they're mini bosses. Look at that. It doesn't even heal half of my health.
we got a red eye. Uh-oh. Two red eyes. Three red eyes? I don't know if the one in the back has red eyes, but I'm betting it does. No, come back! Come on, come on. Yep, back one has red eyes. Didn't want to follow. Maybe these ones are following me really far. Alright, now they're backing up. Duh, I always come up a little bit short on that. Alright, one down. Took all my freaking Estus. Yeah, I think I want to put that ring back on. I don't think I want to get rid of anything else. This is really nice. Stamina, HP, and max equipment load. This is an absolute must. This... I don't know if the Obscure's rolling part actually makes any functional difference, but it's really cool, so I'm not getting rid of that. Yeah, I'm gonna go back to the Estus ring. Which one was it? It's a shortcut. try below. Oh, this is the place I was... Yeah, I was trying to figure out where the heck I activate this mechanism at. I was thinking I activate it from down below, but no, you do it from up above. Why does it say down below? It just... Yeah, you just fall to your death if you fall down below, right? Looks like it. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, no. I think there's another elevator down. Yeah. Hold on. There's a second elevator. This is a special elevator. Yeah, look at that. Oh, good tips. Nothing but an item. It's gotta be something good, right? Titanite slab. Not useful for me right now, but it's a damn good item. Very rare. And they even provide you with a lever, just in case you activate this and then go back. Which actually, I'm gonna do. What's underneath it? Oh. Absolutely nothing. There's a summon sign, there's probably a boss. Yes, this feels like a boss. Try circling around. Try magic. Try... oh.
Oh dear. Another dogged contender. Welcome, unkindled one, purloiner of cinders. Mind you, the mantle of Lord interests me none. The fire-linking curse, the legacy of Lords, let it all fade into nothing. You've done quite enough. Now have your rest.
Elder Prince, and I've got no Estus.
This spot marks our way, but you may rest here too, if you like.
Well, guess what? I think that's a pretty good spot to end this episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm gonna try to take on the Elder Prince.